contact. Send on our former striker telling you everything you need to know. Sheffield United's mindset from here on in. Change sees Chris Bashan push forward into the midfield. Turkey off taking his role on the right hand side of the three centre halves. It's a position that Bashan is very accustomed to play. In the 90th minute. Short kick by Jerry Young.
They're also playing goal for Jerry Young.
Logged into SoundCloud and I can get all my songs off this clip. I can get all my songs off this that I uploaded.
Come on, man.
So
John not to reveal on the day 4 points on the first 2 points.
talked about in their number at the lockdown side. Here they get another one. Friedman gets in. Ron Stewart's there for the finish. And Bramall Lane is bouncing. Robin the man is the Sheffield United's back in the big time.
That tactic of Wilder working to get the ball 3-1. Sheffield United enjoying their time on their back in the top flight. You can learn more about the Premier League Boys with a promoted series hosted by Roger Bennett. Roger goes inside the Premier League viewers' clubs beginning September the 15th.
Test average so far, mid-20s, 150 in six test matches. he's been playing for Glamorgan, making good runs for Glamorgan this year. This is a very, very different kettle of fish. It won't be easy for Miles Labuschagne. Huge pressure, also a huge opportunity in terms of helping his side to see if this test match. It's going to take a launcher for Archer. He's ready and waiting. There seems the shot shine, the natural swing, just the line. Had to play as an abandon.
Yeah, it's a combination of line, close to the cross stump here, as well as the other recording of that. And the reaction was instantaneous from slipfielders, from Archer, who by this stage is already off to square leg somewhere. There's those done his bit, making sure he goes into the ghost cleanly. That's what come down, it's gonna be a big start, bring it. And again, very good afternoon to you, sir. Well, I'm sure you seem to see that well. It was short, it was rather high, and apparently technically one. Looks a bit like a no ball too. Let's get it all done in my ball.
There's a Geoff Rutter has been careful. He's got to run 3 years. He's got to be mindful. Two mistakes, not easy. Neat. Second ball, he's faced. Stayed apart and fall on the ground. for him and now he's back on his feet and ready to start again. And I'd like to make a piece. Good old fashioned days without harness, without grills, people get back and across. There was a forward press in. He was front foot, which gives you balance, yes. The grill, the helmet gives you confidence, but I promise you that 30 years ago would have been a very, very different technique in your place with Jocker Archer at 90 something plus the miles an hour. One say now is good luck. Six overs into this Australian second inning, 20 for 2. And we have change in the comedy box, Ian Botham and Nasser Hussain. So it's that Archer factor again, isn't it? I remember this time yesterday, he was steaming in, albeit from the pavilion end. Now it's from the nursery end. Batting suddenly looks hard work again. Speeds have been up this year. He's up to 84 mile an hour. But he looks a dog over what's coming up at the other end.
Yeah, but I don't think he'll mind that too much. Is there a good chance? There was a moment there where he realised he had nowhere to go then. It followed him.
Lavishane's not in the game, he's been left out, probably been enjoying himself the last 3 days, nice long lunches abroad, an evening out, all of a sudden you're called in for the last day. Face Archer abroad, good luck. No one has ever done it in a test match before. Concussion sub, suddenly been completely switched off to switch on, aim to save for Australia.
Andy Roberts first turned up on the scene playing for Hack, bowling at 100 miles an hour at one end, Tom Mottram at the other end, bowling at 75 miles an hour, and got 100 wickets.
They're all teeing off against him.
Caught mid on, mid off, cover, third man.
Is very similar and that it just comes from nowhere. And I know you've said that he had a couple of bouncers, Andy Roberts, but that's why batters are getting in trouble. He's quick and then all of a sudden, because there's no change in action, he bowls through that action, suddenly it's hitting you, literally.
Andy Roberts got a little soul. And that took 40 there.
Take. Very good take now, Alex.
take. So he's ongoing now, slowly. Excellent. That far away from the bat either.
Well, I must have a theory with him. Obviously, he's played for Glamorgan this year, batted a bit. There's a leg slip in, as opposed to adding to the two slips and a fine gully. So they think he could tickle it down the left side. Let's go leg side, but square up. He's off the mark. It's a cap this game. Come in as a sub, even if it's just for a day, you get a cap. Most of the tests, people have said Stokes has been fine at leg slip. Broad at the end of his run went Stokesy, square up. Keep going square. Another yard, that's it, thumbs up. And he nicked him exactly where he was.
Both of these two bats have quite seen them. Both get across the stumps. So far across, Sydney, that one to Bancroft just before, very close to that. There he is, off you go. Well done, get there. Now, where the ball there is going to go?
Just two slips in a gully for a lad bowling like this, getting it going down the slope. Good route attack, mid on and the mid wickets in.
We don't know both of those guys, that's for sure. Might well need third or fourth slip.
Mid on and a mid wicket, must be there for a reason. Played. Key there was dropping the gloves. This time the helmet was safe, but he didn't want it to flick the gloves.
Follows it, look how it comes back up the slope. That's the problem. It plays out well in the end.
Pushing for a win. 6 for 2. Again, 4 overs, 2 for 13. Stokes has gone back to where he was, he's gone finer. Leg slip, and the ball went. Single figure scores in the series. David Warner, I think 4.5, but if you could time a bit. 3 times the broad and Archer today. Out there for Jack Leach, the left-hander, the two right-handers. There was a bit of talk that maybe Labuschagne would break up the two left-handers in the order to come in ahead. Wade and Head comes, plenty of rough there. Might spin off the pitch as well now for Leach. I think also the reason Leach is coming on is more to do with Archer. In fact, the skipper is saving Archer's legs to follow broad down the hill. That's where he bowled his spell, his instructive spell yesterday. Thank you.
debate who was going to be the nursery end. It's going to be Chris Wokes, not Jack Leach. 2-9 to win. 8 wickets for England to go 1-all. 39 overs remaining. They've got to bowl those overs, weather depending, light depending. Stats going in the right direction. Stats here very impressive. Bat and ball. A little bit short in the first innings. Fraction one day length splice of the bat. See if Wokes can get it a bit fuller. Variation just came on, came straight on, or maybe a little bit up the slope.